How old are you?
41.
Can each one of you please shout out how old are you?
41.
40. Are all of you cannot be 41? Not his age, your age. Everyone's 41 today. 1 second. 31. Achha, 31. 1 minute. Amitabh bhai, how old is the kurta you're wearing?
Two.
Two, na? So the dress which you're wearing is 2 years and the other dress which you're wearing is 41 years. How old are you? How old are you? 41 plus 2, 43. 1 minute. Maths kuch nahi. Each one of you also have to give the answer. The age of the kurta, 2. The age of the other dress that I am wearing, 41. How old am I? Eternal. That was the answer, not 43. Now, ye sirf aise taali bajane ke liye nahi hai. It is to understand that I am not this age, which means how old am I? Eternal means what? Eternal means ageless, which means, now 1 minute Amitabh, remain standing. 41 years before, where was this soul? 41 years before he entered into this costume, 41 plus 9 months, okay? Entered that costume. Before that, where was the soul? Huh? No. If you were coming from Brahmalok, there would have been no stain on the soul. It would be pure, divine, white. Where have we come from with the stains? Where did we come from? We were in another costume. Khade rehna ek minute, huh? So now 41. Please everyone relate yourself to this. 41 years in this costume, so much must have happened in these 41 years. Family, which city I'm staying, which country, which school, which college, what exposure, what friends, what media. So much exposure which creates sanskars, right? But these are sanskars of only 41 years. Now before that I was in another costume, maybe 100 years in that body. Another family, another region, another role, another relationship. How many sanskars in those 100 years? Can you see how many are recording? Then before that in another 100 years, and before that in another 100 years, and before that in another 100 years. What all would be there in the soul? Can we see what all could be there on the soul? Yes? How many recordings, how many impressions, how many sanskars? Rashmi, khade ho jao. Now one day, this soul got married to this soul. Now this soul has sanskars of 41 plus 100 plus 100 plus 100 plus 100 plus 100, so many years. And got married to another soul who is not going to ask the age of her body, but it doesn't matter. How old is the body? Yeah. Never do this. Why should I not tell my age? But my age is eternal. That's only the age of the dress we are wearing. How much?
35.
So 35 now. Look at this. Even this 41 and 35 environment was different before they got married. We don't know what both of them have gone through in their childhood, in their school. Please look at all this. What gets recorded on the soul? Before 35, another 100, another 100, another 100, another 100. And now one day, these two souls are told, you are going to live the rest of your life together. Vibration of the room has changed. Bejo. Ek minute. Can you see what is happening? Who is getting married to who? Costume, no. Two souls with not baggage, lots of sanskars. Sanskars not of one lifetime. Sanskars of many, 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 many lifetimes. Suddenly are going to live together. So how much ever you get the Janam Patri matched? Why did you laugh? You got yours matched over before. Which is okay, that's a science. That science can only tell you this and this sanskar can match. But if all after matching all the Janam Patris, if it worked, then so many of us wouldn't be in court, right? They all had matched their Janampatri before they got married. And there are some whose Janampatri did not match. And they said, it's okay if it doesn't match. We're still going to make this relationship work beautifully. And they did it. And they did it. So, every time I look at another individual, I'm not going to look at the individual, the costume which they are wearing. It's as if the kurta of his and the salwar kameez of hers coming into a relationship. Ye koi rishta? No. Similarly, the body of one and body of the other is not a relationship. Similarly, the label put on the two of them that I am so and so, I am so and so is not coming into a relationship. Who is coming into a relationship? A soul and another soul, and both the souls have carried thousands of years of sanskars. And then we look at each other and say, I expect you to be my way. Possible? 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 I expect you to be my way. Possible? Hanji? So what should be normal? I expect you, or I understand and I accept you. What is normal? Accept you means I understand that you are a soul on a journey who's carried many, 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 many things of so many lifetimes. And so I understand you, that you could be carrying rejection, you could be carrying hurt, you could be carrying pain, you could be carrying mistrust, you could be carrying doubt, you could be carrying insecurity, you could be carrying ego. I understand it all. I was not expecting a perfect soul in my life. I was getting married to a soul who's on a journey. There is a difference. So from today, change the way you perceive the other person. Not just in a husband and wife, every relationship. And people whom you work with. Can you see how we will start understanding them differently? Now someone is in pain due to whatever reason that they are carrying with them. And we say, I expect you to be a certain way. Even if they want to be that way, they cannot be that way. Unless, of course, they start healing themselves and we help them to heal themselves, that is a second thing. But first thing is, I have to accept them as they are. So, I love you is not to be the line. The line has to be, I accept you. Because we are in pain, we are crying and we are telling the other person, but I love you. Ek unsa love hai. Rote rote thodi hota hai love. Kitna rote hai while saying I'm loving you. Are that is not love. That time it's not love. That time it is I am in pain. So love is not a word. It is a vibration. And none of us are right now at that vibration of 100% perfect love. None of us. Because that 100% perfect love is when we are 100% soul conscious stage. Flawless soul. Flawless. But now we are on that journey of shifting from where we are to reaching that stage. And so the first thing that you will benefit when you start meditating on a daily basis and removing our old labels of egos, the first thing that benefits is relationships. All the couples, how have the last 2 days been since you're here? Anji? Manish bhai? No fight? Very good. तो एक ऑप्शन ये है कि यहीं रह जाओ एक ऑप्शन ये है डोंट गो बैक होम स्टे हियर एंड दूसरा ऑप्शन ये है कैरी दिस एनर्जी बैक होम एंड देयर विल बी नो फाइट्स हो ही नहीं सकते वंस देयर इज अ डॉक्टर एंड अ पेशेंट डोंट फाइट दे डोंट फाइट अ हीलर एंड अ पेशेंट नेवर फाइट बट व्हाई यू नो बिकॉज अ डॉक्टर हैज नो एक्सपेक्टेशंस फ्रॉम अ पेशेंट द डॉक्टर जस्ट नोज आई एम हियर To heal, which means which energy? Which means which energy? I am here to heal. That's why this energy is needed. You go and meet a healer and you cry and you say, they don't say, why are you coming to me and crying? They say, I am here to heal. the energy of giving, that is the seva bhav. So most important seva bhav is within family. Within family, sabse pehle unki seva karo. Charity begins at home. So sabse pehli seva kiski? Khud ki. Till I take care of myself, I can't take care of other people. To sabse pehli seva khud ki, dusri seva family, and third, it automatically starts radiating to everybody else. Take 10 seconds, close your eyes, and look at your family members with this perspective now. Remove the label, don't look at the body, just look at that soul with the compassion and the understanding that I was looking at them only in these last few years. But that was just the body the last few years. This soul has been on such a long journey. Each costume, different families, different places, different environments, different situations, different experiences. What all they must have recorded and come. So ego is attachment to a wrong image of myself, means body, nationality, caste, religion, relationship, everything that I've acquired is mine, it is not I. So wrong image means I, the soul, is the true image. Apart from that, everything is a wrong image of I. It is an image of mine, that is all mine, this body is mine, but it's not I. And every morning we look in the mirror and we say, how am I looking today? It's not how am I looking today. It's how is my body looking today. So that was all ego. So now onwards, it doesn't mean that I'm becoming perfect today. It just means my ability to understand people will change. And I will say, earlier we would say, why are they so insecure? Why are they so jealous? Why are they this? Why? No why, all whys are over. How I will handle that sanskar will be my next step of the journey. But first my whys have to be over. Because why are they like this is a rejection. It is a rejection. And then we actually say to them, how can you be like this? Kis kis ne bola ye line? Apni apni bhasha mein. How can you be like this? I love you, but how can you be like this? And then the other person looks at you and says, how can you be like this? So those hows and whys are now over just with understanding. Then we will take the second step of how we are going to shift to accepting that sanskar. But without understanding, acceptance doesn't happen. Like last month, there was an earthquake. Thousands of souls have left the body. There was a war. Thousands of souls have left the body. And every year in our city, in our country, we are seeing people around us, COVID. COVID people left the body. Now, when a soul leaves suddenly like that, and especially if they've left in some situation like this, now just visualize somebody leaves in an earthquake. Just look at, visualize this scene. What would be the last recording on the soul before they leave? Hanji? Let's list the sanskars. One, pain. Two, fear. Fear of what? Fear of dying. Okay, very good. What else? Helplessness. Very good. What else? Incomplete. Okay, fear of losing family. Because when there is some calamity like that, you actually with these eyes see everything happening. You actually, the bridge collapse that had happened last 2 months back. Can we just visualize one evening a family of four goes for a holiday? And there you are, just visualize this right now. There you are on that bridge, eating, laughing, singing, you know, enjoying. And within a minute, everything changes. And literally, you are holding on to your child and that child is slipping out of your hands. And you are seeing all this here and it's getting recorded here. And suddenly you were a perfect happy family and suddenly everything is over. What gets recorded on the soul? What will get recorded on the soul? There's so much fear of losing. Fear of losing people is ingrained so deep. And now the soul will enter in the womb of a mother. And few months later, a happy smiling baby is born. And everybody feels a perfect child is born in my house. And then suddenly when that child is 2 years old, 3 years old, that child is very scared to be on their own. And they will cling on to you, don't leave me, I don't want to be alone in the room, I cannot stay alone in the dark. And we are like, kya darpok bachcha hai ye? And that's the first rejection that soul gets. The soul doesn't remember why the soul is experiencing that sanskar, because the soul will not remember the incident. But the soul, for that soul, that fear is very real, very real. But everyone around them finds it very unreasonable. But तुम्हें किस बात का इतना डर लग रहा है? चलो, 3 years, 4 years, okay, we will understand that this child doesn't want to be alone. Today that person is 30 years old. Got into a relationship, got married. Constant fear of losing the other person. Because nobody healed that in 30 years for that soul. In fact, added more to the pain by being judgmental, by comparing with other children, by criticizing and saying, darpok hai, look at your brother, sister, they are so strong, look at you. So we actually add pain to people's pain by not understanding why they are what they are. And that's why understanding a soul is so important. So we can criticize them, we can reject them, and sabse zyada, we compare them to other souls. We compare them to their siblings, we compare them to neighbors' children, we compare them to strangers. Look at that child. But that child is another soul on a journey. So never ever compare anyone with anyone. Even at work, never compare one person with another person. Because they are not one role and another role. They are two souls with very, very, very long journey. So comparing two people is disrespect. It's disrespect. Because there's nothing common between the two of them.